Talking about the dream state and deep sleep state and so on, and waking state also, it was shown how the avidya, kama, karma, all of these are the dharma of the anatman. Sesha, kama, karma, avidyanam, anatma, dharmatva, pratipadana, dvarena. So that is how that Shruti did very effectively. So how avidya, kama and karma, all of these belong to anatma and not to atma. Mokshitaha. This Atma was thought to be ignorant. Atma was thought to be Kami. Atma was thought to be Karta and Bhokta. And so the ignorance, Kama, Kartrutva, Bhoktrutva, Kamitvam, all of these, Atma was released from these notions. That look, all of this belongs to Anatma, does not belong to Atma. Because these things drop off one by one. Avidya also drops off. In the dream state it was shown how a wise man also knows, even in the dream also, how he is all, you know. And that's avidya also was dropped off, and kama also is dropped off, and karma also is dropped off, because in deep sleep state the kama karma are not there. In that way atma was released from being possessed of these attributes. Shodh mokshitaha paramatmaham apaditaha. And thus it was shown how Atma is in fact Paramatma. So Jivatma is none other than Paramatma, because the Jivatvam all belongs to Anatma. Para evayam nanyahiti. Hey, what I thought to be Jivatma is in fact none other than Paramatma. Ishas. But inasmuch as Tattvasi Mahavakya established the identity between Brahma and Atma, therefore, so whatever Visheshana that are applicable to Brahma are also applicable to Atma, and therefore this is Yathartha Stuti and not Avidyamana Stuti. So whenever this wise person is said to be Esha Sarveshwara, Esha Bhutadipati, Esha Bhutapala, is it merely to make him, just flattering him? He says no, Yathartha Stuti, because he is identical to, he knows himself to be identical to Brahma. He knows himself as self of all. He knows himself to be Adhisthanam, the substrate of the entire universe. And that's how he knows himself to be Sarveshwara, Bhutapala, Bhutadipati. Therefore, Esha Yathardha Stutiheva, Natu Avidyamana Stutihi, Iti Bhava. So that is the first part of the verse 981. Saesha Ishvara Sakshadidi Shrutya Pradashitaha. So Swayam Jyotishya Shabditaha Saesha Ishvara Sakshad. That alone is Sakshad Ishvara Iti Shrutya Pradashitaha. Tatra Visheshana Visheshatva Vibhagam Darshayati. Then the verse says, Visheshana, Visheshyatvam, Ishitavya, Ishayoho, Iha, Esha, Sarveshwara. See, when you're Ishvara, when you're a Lord, then there is someone who you lord over. So when there is Ishita, the Lord, there is Ishitavya, the one who is lorded over. So when there is a master, then there is a servant. There is a king, then there are subjects. There is the Lord, then there are those who are in fact ruled by him. When there is a ruler, there are ruled. There is a controller, there are controlled. So this ruler is always a sapeksha. He is always a relative noun with a reference to someone or those who are ruled. Similarly also when you call somebody the controller, that's also with a reference to those who are controlled. Therefore, Visheshana, Visheshatvam, Ishitavya, Ishayoho, Iha. Isha is the Lord, the ruler. Ishitavya, the ruled. So that is Visheshana, Visheshana, Visheshatvam here. The Visheshana, Visheshatva, the qualified, the qualification, the qualified is Ishitavya and Isha. Iha iti Shrutihi Ukta. Having said that, he is going to negate that. But basically, when you say Esha Bhutadipati, Esha Bhutapala, Esha Setu, Sarveshwara. Then Sarveshwara, Bhutadipatihi, Bhutapal, all of these are Visheshanalavesha. And so, Esha becomes the Visheshya, all of become the Visheshana. And also, when you say Sarveshwara, then Sarveshwara is the reference of someone who is ruled. And so, ruler and ruled. So then the rule becomes Visheshana of the ruler. Ishitavya and Isha. Isha and Ishitavya. So the ruled becomes Visheshana of the ruler. That is how this one says here. And subsequently we will say that the Visheshana, Vishesha, all of these do not apply in the primary sense. But as a stuti, all of this is so yathokta seva samstuti. This is indeed the stuti of the wise person. And not the stuti is totally a flattery, inasmuch as at least a level of knowledge, the wise person knows that I am Sarveshwara. Not the level of upadhi. At the level of understanding, he knows I am Sarveshwara. I am Bhutadipadhi, I am Bhutapalaha. In that sense, the stuti also is not out of place or not wrong. But from his standpoint, he is, from the standpoint of others, he may not be. There is others evaluating from the standpoint of upadhi, so he may not be. But that's why he evaluates himself as consciousness, he is. But then, again, it will not be in the primary sense, that will be stated in the subsequent verses. Okay, we'll continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Daya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Kratau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti Shanti Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namah Hari Om Yoyam Vijnanamayah Pranesho Yesha Antarude Akashastasmin Chede Sarvasya Vashi Sarvasya Shanah Sarvasya Adhipatihi Sana Sadhuna Karmana Bhuyan No Eva Sadhuna Kaniyan Esha Sarveshwarah Esha Bhutadhipatihi Esha Bhutapalah Esha Setur Vidharanah Esham Lokanam Sambhedaya Tametam Vedan Vachanaina Brahmana Vividishante Yajnena Danena Tapasa Nashakena Etameva Viditva Mudir Bhavate Etameva Pravrajana Loka Vinchanta Pravrajande Etad Dhasma Vaitat Purve Vidvams of Prajanda Kamayante Kim Praja Karishyamaha Yeshan Noyam Atmayan Lokaiti Ehasma Putrai Shanayas Savitai Shanayas Salokai Shanayas Chavyuthaya Atha viksha charyan charande. Yahye putraishana savittaishana. Yavittaishana salogaishana. Vekhyete eshane eva bhavatah. Saeshane tinetyatma. Agrishyo nahi grishyate. Ashiryo nahi shiryate. Asango nahi sajyate. Asito navyasate. Narishyate. Etumuhai vaite na taratahite. Mite. Atah kalyana makarva mite. Uhe uhai vaisha ete tarate. Nainam krita krite tapatah. Reading the Karodapatra, beginning from page 1269. Puro bhagas samastopi vedantartha buddhe yatha bhote vedasya tathatha pratipadyate. Samastopi puro bhagah vedantartha buddhe yatha bhote. The entire puro bhagah, that is karma kanda vibhaga, yatha vedantartha buddhe bhavati, how that becomes a means for knowing the meaning of Vedanta, that is how it prepares a seeker for the study of the Vedanta. Atha prasipadyate, that is what is being in fact expounded, delineated by this passage. Vedantartham yathayatam anudyashvitiradarat Savaityadinoktartham pravaktum upachakrame. Savaityadina vedantartham yathayatam anudya. So savayesha mahanajatma, all the way up to, so by that anudya, reiterating the yathayatam, how the first two chapters called the Madhukanda expounded the same truth with the pradhanya, agama pradhanya, revelation was the predominant factor. The next two chapters, so that we call the Munikanda, how that revealed the truth or how that expounded it through the logical reasoning. And elsewhere also, other Vedantas also reveal the same truth. So Vedantartham yathayatam anudya sava esha ityadina. So by this statement or by this passage, sava esha, how the Shruti in fact reiterates or recapitulates all that this text has said, and what the Vedanta, the texts also say. Then Shruti adara duktartham pravaktum upachakrame. And then Shruti, with great eagerness, adara duktartham, as to how karmakanda is the means for or the preparation for the jnanakanda, uktartham pravaktum upachakrame tametam vedanu vachayana. By that, Shruti proceeds to say how the karmakanda is the means for the preparation for the jnanakanda. Paramarshas sashabdena puroktasya. So, sava sahashabda puroktasya sashabdena paramarshah. So, by the word saha, the Shruti brings to our mind, wants to bring to our recollection what has been stated earlier in the Jyotir Brahmana, the Jivatman. Vaishabdha prasiddhitah smutaye. And how that Jivatma is someone that is well known to us, and that is brought to our memory. So saha brings to our mind the idea of something that is already stated. And what it is stated by Vai. So Vai shows the prasiddhi, something that is well known or well established, and that is a Jivatma. Mrutu janmadi dharminah. So saha in fact refers to Jivatma. Sopadhika Atma. Murdu Janmadi Dharminah. One possessed of dharma of Janma Mrityu. Dhruvanta Mantra Namna Mantra Amna Yoktah. Esha Ityabhidhiyate. So, Ajatma Mahan Dhruva, so that one. So that mantra is brought to our memory again by this Eva Esha. Mahanaja iti vachaha tad visheshana siddhaye. And so Mahanaja, the word Ajaha in fact releases the Jivatma. So word Ajaha releases the Jivatma from all the vikas. And that's how Ajaha in fact, so Vishodhanam Vashodhanam. So it releases the notion of the Jivatma, it releases the understanding of Jivatma from all the notions. And then Mahan, in fact, equates it with Brahma, because Mahan is the Visheshanam applicable to Brahma. So Mahan Ajaha, in that way, this shows here the identity that the Jivatma is none other than Paramatma, who is none other than Brahma. Anve vidrekartham ekartha yoyam ityadikashudhi. So yoyam vijnanamaya praneshu eshontarde akasha tasmin shete. That passage is anve vidrekartha. So tvam padartha jivasya avasthatre sambandha abhavena shuddhatvam nirnitam. So how that Shruti shows that this Vijnanamaya Atma in fact is unconnected to three states of awareness. Yesha antardaya akasha tasmin shete. He obtains in the space that obtains within the heart. That means it is different from the heart as well as different from the space. And different from avyakrata. Or he obtains in the very Paramatma, that is the nature. Swasvabhava, in the state of deep sleep, the Jivatma in fact reduces to the state of Paramatma, that is its true nature. And so, Anvaya and Vatareka, when the three states are there, the Vijnanamaya Atma is there. And even when the three states are not there, the Vijnanamaya Atma is. Yoyamitya Adishrutihi Visheshana Visheshyartham Sarvasya Iti Tathavachaha. Then continuing, sarvasya vashi, sarvasya ishanah, sarvasya adhipatihi. So it shows, so these are all the visheshanas of Brahma. And Brahma becomes the visheshana of pratyegatma. So, visheshana visheshyartham sarvasya iti tathavachah. So this vachah sarvasya is for visheshana visheshyartham. यत्र किंचित् वक्तव्यं तस्य प्रागेव चोक्तितः सामानादिकरण्यादेः निहतत् पुनरुच्यते. And so we are not at the moment, we don't see the need of elaborating this idea of samanadikaranyam. That the words in a Mahavakya enjoy the relationship that is called samanadikaranyam, the vachyartha enjoy the relationship that is called visheshana visheshya, and the swarupa enjoy the relationship of lakshya lakshyartha. Lakshya lakshya. Prageva cha uktitah. Since all of this has been stated earlier, discussed earlier, samanadikaranyadehe and visheshana visheshya etc. ihatat punah na uchyate. And therefore, we are not seeing the need of elaborating that here. Bhuyan cha sadhunaneti. Then, so sahana sadhuna karmana bhuyan no eva asadhuna kaniyan. Iti jnanasya phalam uchyate. So this is the phalam, the result of knowledge of the wise person as to how he becomes free from the effect of karma, either punya karma or pap karma. Esha sarveshwaroktya cha yathoktasyav samstutihi. Esha sarveshwara, esha bhutadipadihi, esha bhutapalaha. Is not to be merely looked upon as repetition of sarvasya adhipati, sarvasya vashi, etc. But then, yathoktasyeva samstutihi. So what has been stated, it is for the extolling, the praise of the stuti of that. So it is to be looked upon as stuti and not merely punarukti. Yaduktam bhavatyatra yoyamityadana auditah vivittah kama karmadehe swayam jyotisra shabditah. Yaduktam bhavati. So this is the meaning. So from the verse 79, 979. 980, right. Mahavakyatatvayam. Sattvam Brahma, Tvam Vishnu Vityadivat, Avidyamanastri Shaityashankhya. So this is the, is a stuti of avidyamana, stuti of something that is non-existing, says now. Yadaduktam bhavati. So this stuti, so when you actually praise this vijnanamaya atma, you say that, sana sadhana, sadhana karmana bhuyan, no eva sadhana kaniyan, and that is in fact the phala of the jnana, of the wise person. And then, esha sarveshwara, therefore, in reply to that, he said, yadaduktam bhavati. Iti atra, so when Bhashyakara said, yadaduktam bhavati, and explained, atra yoyam ityadanavuditaha, vijnanamaya, the vijnanamaya atma, who has been stated by yoyam vijnanamaya praneshu. So, in that discussion, vivektaha kama karmade. So, by in that Jyotir Brahmana, by the discussion of these three states of awareness, it was shown how this vijnanamaya atma, in fact, is free from avidya, kama, karma, that all of them belong to anatma. Vivektaha, he was separated from that. And Swayam Jyotishya Shabditaha. And then he was, it was established how Vijnanama Jivatma is none other than Swayam Jyotihi, the self-effulgent Atma. The idea is that Tattvamadi Vakyat Aikya Siddhi Esha Yathata Stutiheva. That means, so, in short, what you think of Vijnanamaya Atma is not merely Jivatma, but in his true nature, he is in fact Shuddha Jyoti, so Swayam Jyotihi Chaitanyam. And the Swayam Jyotish Chaitanyam is none other than Brahma, Paramatma. So, Esha Sarveshwara, Esha Bhutadipati, Esha Bhutapala. If all these attributes apply to Paramatma, since Paramatma is none other than Jivatma, therefore, they can apply also to this wise person. Therefore, it is not avidyamanastuti. Saesha Ishvara Sakshat Idi Shrutya Pradarshitah. And therefore, Saesha Ishvara Sakshat. Therefore, he is in fact Sarveshwara. Bhutadipati. Bhutapala hai, idhi shrutya pradashita hai. So that vijnanamaya. So vijnanamaya atma is in fact said directly to be Ishvara hai, Sarveshwara hai, Bhutadipati hi, Bhutapala hai. Then the Tika said, Tatra visheshana visheshyatva vibhagam darshayati. Visheshana visheshyatvam ishitavya ishayoho iha. Visheshana visheshyatvam ishitavya ishayoho iha. Then here, so ishitavya and isha, the law, the ruler and the one who is ruled. So isha, isha and ishitavya, visheshana visheshyatvam. So then there is a, this is a relationship of, again, tatpada and tvampada, the relationship of visheshana and visheshyatva. So the qualifying and the one who is qualified. In the qualification. That is further explained. Now we are on this, in this handout, page 1238 and the verse 982. Ishvarena visheshanena jivasya visheshyatva phalamaha. So jiva is visheshya. Vijnanamaya Atma is visheshya, qualified, and Ishvara, so Isha and Ishitavya. So generally speaking, Jiva is Ishitavya, the one is ruled, and Ishvara and the Brahma is Isha, the ruler. That's the general relationship at the level of Upadhi. So Ishvarena visheshanena jivasya visheshyatva phalamaha. In fact, one becomes ruled only because there is a ruler, or one becomes ruler with reference to the ruled. In that sense, the visheshana visheshyatva is there. So God can be called ruler only with reference to the jiva who is ruled. Or the jiva can be called ruled only with reference to God who is the ruler. Had there been no ruler, there would have been no rule. Had there been no ruler, there would have been no ruler. In that sense, the relationship is called Visheshana Visheshya. That is, one is required for the other, or one qualifies the other. And Vartikara will show how this obtains merely at the level of Upadhi, otherwise at the Upahita, at the level of the one that is conditioned, naturally there is no relationship at all. So what the Vedantins want to establish is, in fact, there is no relationship at all between Jiva and Ishvara, in the ultimate sense. At the level of Upadhi, yes, there is a relationship. Therefore, Visheshana, Visheshada, between the Padartha, between the Vachyartha, one is Ishvara, other is Jiva. And so one gets qualified by the other. So he is called Ishitavya with reference to Isha, he is called Isha with reference to Ishitavya. But inasmuch as Ishitavya, being ruled and being ruler, both of them are Agantuka, both of them are superimposed in that sense, in fact, therefore, the ultimate relationship is at the level of Swarupa, is nothing but Lakshana and Lakshya. That all the Upadhis become the Lakshanas, and what is Lakshya is Nirupadhika. Therefore, here it is said, Ishvarena Visheshanena Jivasya Visheshatve Phalamaha. Because what was said is, this Sarvasya Vashi, Sarvasya Ishanaha. So all of that are they in fact the Visheshana of Brahma. And Brahmi Bhutaha Vijnanamaya. So Vijnanamaya, the Jivatma, on account of knowledge, is the one who has become Brahma. And therefore, then Brahma becomes the Visheshana of Jivatma, because Brahmi Bhutaha. And Brahma is Sarvasya Vashi, Sarvasya Ishanaha, Sarvasya Adhipatihi, etc. So the verse 982 says, Yamapeksha, Yamapekshaishvaratvam syat, tattavat pratishedhati, visheshana virodhitvat, mahatkham kumbhakam yatha. Yamapeksha, Ishvaratvam syat. The Ishvaratva is always with reference to apeksha of Ishitavya. Yamapeksha, Ishvaratvam syat, tattavat pratishedhati. So with reference to Jiva, the Ishvara is Ishvara, Paramatma is Ishvara, but tat tavat pratishedati, that very Jivatvam itself is, and therefore the Ishvaratvam also becomes denied. Visheshana virodhitvat, because there is a virodha. And the Tikakar explains that. See, sarveshvaratvadi visheshana samarthyat, vishesha jivastam, Ishitavyatvadi apagachati ityartha. Visheshana virodhitvat. Because when Shruti says that the Vijnanamaya is Sarveshvaraha, so Bhutadhipatihi, Bhutapalaha, when Jiva is called all of this, he cannot be called Sarveshvaraha, he cannot be called the ruler of all if he is ruled. Sarveshvara is what? Sarvasishvara. So if now this wise person, the Vijnanamaya Atma, is the Lord of all means he must be one who is not lorded by anybody. And so ruler of all, that means the one who is not ruled by anybody. And thus, that is what is said here, tat tavat pratishedati. There is no more, it's called ruled. So when the ruled is not there, the ruler also is not there. So yam apeksha ishvaratvam syat. So ishvaratvam is with reference to Ishitavya. Ishitavya means one who is ruled. But when one who is ruled, namely Vijnanamaya Atma, he himself is called Sarveshvara, Bhutadhipatihi, Bhutapala, etc., then being ruled is denied. There is no more ruled. And therefore, there is no ruler also. Visheshana, Visheshatvam, Ishitavya, Ishayohoiha. Now, Visheshana Virodhitva, that's all. So, see here, Sarveshvara, Sarveshvaratvadi, Visheshana samarthyat, Visheshya jivastam, Ishitavyatvadi apagachati. Sarveshvaratvadi Visheshana samarthyat. This is called Sarveshvara Bhutadhipati. So samarthyat, samarthya means here arthapatti. So shrutarthapatti, that Shruti could not have said it if he was in fact a jiva. सो विशेषण सामर्थ्यात विशेष्य जीवस्थम ईशितव्यत्वादि अपगच्छति. सो जीवा इज नॉर्मली ईशितव्य एंड व्हाट एवर यू नो. सो वन इज वशी अदर इज वश्य ईश्वर ईशितव्य अधिपति ही एंड सो व्हाट इज अधिपति ही देन अधिपत्य व्हाट एवर यू नो. सो दिस रिलेशनशिप इज देयर नो. All that relationship goes away. Patiyan palita, adhipalita, you can say in fact. So, ishitavyas, so jivastha, ishitavyatvadi apagacchati. And therefore, by calling him Sarveshwara, etc., all of these being ruled and being protected and being controlled, all of this goes away from him. So, this is what is meant. Saesha ishvara sakshadade shrutya pradash. No. यम अपेक्ष ईश्वरत्वम स्यात् तत्तावत् प्रतिषेधते. सो विथ रेफरेंस टू व्हाट वन कैन बी कॉल्ड ईश्वर दैट ईशितव्य इटसेल्फ सो श्रुति डिनाइज इन विज्ञानमे. निषेधकर्ता विशेषण विशेष्य भाव तस्य निषेधकत्वे हेतुमः. सो दिस वाज एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑन द फर्स्ट लाइन. यह अपेक्ष ईश्वरत्व से आत तत्तावत प्रतिषेधति. निषेधकर्ता विशेषण विशेष्य भाव तस्य निषेधकत्वे हेतुमः. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज दिस विशेषण विशेष्य भाव इटसेल्फ बिकम निषेधकर्ता. व्हेन जीवा बिकम विशेषण ऑफ ईश्वर एंड वाइस वर्सा दैट वेरी भाव. सो दैट शोज अ कॉन्ट्रडिक्शन. So what happens in Mahavakya is that when we say that the Vachyarthas enjoy the Visheshana Visheshya Bhava, then there is a contradiction. And that contradiction requires that all the contradictory elements should be negated. And that's how the establish the identity between the non-contradicted, the Samanamsa becomes established. So whatever Viruddhamsa is there in Jiva and Ishvara, they become negated, and that's how in Aviruddhamsa the identity is established. So it is that very Visheshana Visheshya Bhava that requires us. How can Jiva be equal to Ishvara, you know? How can Jiva be Ishvara? That is, how can Jiva is Ishvaratvam? If Jiva is equal to Ishvara, if Tad is equal to Tvam, so Vachyartha of Tad is Ishvara. Vachyadavtvam is Jiva, then Jiva is Ishvara. Then Jiva must have Ishvaratvam, and Ishvara must have Jivatvam. Then alone both of them can be equal. Like when you say blue lotus, the lotus must have blueness, and blue must have lotusness. Now if that is compatible, then you don't go further, that's fine, you call it blue lotus. So that is called Vishesha Visheshana Sambandha, and that's how Visheshana Sambandha is there, that's how the Vakyartha, blue lotus. But here when you say Tat is Tvam, then Tvam is Jiva and Tat is Ishvara. That means then Ishvara must have Jivatvam in order to be Ishvara for being equal to Jiva. And Jiva must have Ishvaratvam for Jiva to be same as Ishvara. And that is a contradiction. So this contradiction that obtains itself becomes Nishedakarta. That Visheshana Visheshya Bhava that Jiva and Ishvara enjoy, on account of their being in the same adhikarana, that itself requires a nisheda of all the viruddhamsa or the contradictory elements. So nisheda karta visheshana visheshya bhava tasya nisheda katve hetumaha. How come this visheshana visheshya bhava becomes nisheda karta? That it becomes the karta, the agent of negation. So next line said, Visheshana Virodhitvāda. Because Jīva cannot possess Ishvaratvam. Because one is Ishitavya. Ishitavya cannot be Ishvara. And Ishvara cannot be Ishitavya. Contradiction. So Visheshana Virodhitvāda. See, there is a Virodha or contradiction in the Visheshana. Therefore, these contradict elements are negated. That's what Tika says. ईश्वरत्वेन विरोधित्वात् तेन विशेषित जीवगत ईशितव्यस्य निवृत्ति इत्यर्थः. सो व्हेन ऑन वन हैंड दैट इज हाउ देयरफॉर वार्तिककारः सेज how this establishes the Visheshana Vishesha Bhava. So by calling this Jvijnanamaya Atma, the enlightened self, as Esha Sarveshwara, Esha Bhutadipadhi, Esha Bhutapala, he is equated to Ishvara. That's why the Visheshana Vishesha Bhava was said. That Tat is equated to Tvam, and Tvam is equated to Tat, and that is clearly stated here. That Jvijnanamaya Atma, who is Tvam Pada, is Tvam Padartha, is none other than Sarveshwara, is Ishvara. Now if he is Ishvara, then he cannot be Jiva. Therefore, Jivatvam must be given up. If Jivatvam is given up, then Ishvaratva also gets given up, because Ishvaratva is only Yam Apeksha Ishvaratvam Syat. So that Jivatvam, in with reference to which one can be, the Lord can be called Lord, when Jivatvam is negated by the Visheshana Visheshya Bhava. So very Visheshana Visheshya Bhava itself becomes the agent of negating the contradict elements, and that is how the Ishvaratvam also gets negated. So Visheshita Jivakata Ishitavyasva Ishvaratvena Virodhitvat. And so that Ishitavya, which obtains the Jivatma, since that is contradicted with Ishvaratva, because it is called Sarveshvara, Tasya Nivruttihi. And therefore, from the Jivatma, Ishitavyatvam, that is being ruled, that is Nivruti, that is negated. that means the Vijnanamaya Atma is released from being Ishitavya. And therefore, the Paramatma also becomes released from the idea of being Ishvara. Mahatkham Kumbakham Yatha. So when you say Mahatkham Kumbakham Yatha, Mahakasha is Ghatakasha. So when Ghatakasha is said to be Mahakasha, that Tikagara says, Ghatakasha Mahakasha iti ukte, Ghatakashastha Parichinnatva Nivruttihi Nivruttivat, Esha Sarveshvara iti ukte, Jivagada Ishtavyatva Nivruttihi Diyaha. So Ghatakasha Mahakasha iti ukte, Ghatakashastha Parichinnatva Nivruttihi. In no way Ghatakasha, part space, can be the pervading or pervading space, unless that space partness. So part space is actually qualified by partness, and the total space is qualified by pervasiveness. So these call Mahakasha only with reference to Ghatakasha. But when Ghatakasha is equal to Mahakasha, then Ghatatvam cannot remain in the Akasha, and Mahatvam also goes away. So Ghatakasho Mahakasha idyukte Ghatakashastha Parichinnatva Nivruttivata. So how the Parichinnatva, the smallness, littleness, limitedness in the Ghatakasha, that becomes released. Ghatakasha becomes released from the idea of Ghatatvam or limitedness. That's how, just by in this way, Shruti wants, Shruti negates everything. This, you know, so however we understand Ghatakasha is Mahakasha or Mahakasha. So when Ghatakasha is understood in our intellect as Mahakasha, whatever process happens there, that cannot be unless the limitedness of Ghatakasha is dropped. That means when it is said Ghatakasha is Mahakasha, our mind understands that Ghatakashatvam or limitedness is Mithya. And so that shape of the Ghata is something that is superimposed upon the Akasha, and so partiness in the space is Mithya. Space cannot have that shape of partiness, and therefore it belongs to Upadhi, it belongs to part and not to space. How our mind is able to see that? That's it. Similarly also, when Chaitanya is Vijnanamaya, the consciousness is called Jiva, but then consciousness cannot have Jivatvam, because when consciousness is equated to Brahma, it cannot have Jivatvam, the Jivatvam drops. If somebody can drop it like that, that's it. You don't need anything more to do. If one can be as simple as dropping this stuff, then theek hai, baba, chalo, nahi hai to kya hai, that Jivatvam is given up. Why should I hold on to this individuality? Why should I always want to promote it and always want to assert it and stuff like that, you know, and seek my security from that? What's the need? If it can be dropped like that is called jnana marga, that's all. Which doesn't require anything else to do. No bhakti, karma, nothing is required. This is all that you need. It is simply drop in view of seeing that this ghatatvam is just superimposed. It doesn't belong to space. Similarly also, all that sense of limitation all belongs to upadhi. It doesn't belong to Chaitanya. That's it. It's dropped. In that sense, one can say that merely intellect is enough. Mere understanding is enough to become free from every complex. And once a person becomes free from complex, all the results come. Because, you see, all the love and everything will automatically come because it is there. Right now it is all stifled because the sense of individuality in fact blocks everything. Blocks the expression of myself, really, tremendously. So the idea of smallness all the time becomes an obstacle to my free expression of my being. And when that is not there, I remain what I am. And then I am always a loving, giving, wonderful person. That I am, everybody is. Except that lovingness, givingness, wonderfulness, everything that I am is just bottled up, stifled up. Because of a need to all the time believe that I am so and so. And therefore I am distinct from others. And therefore I am something. And therefore I am different from others. The need to keep on holding on to that. What it does is, the very need to always establish myself or maintain myself a distinct entity, all it does is, it denies me of all the glory or all the wonderfulness that I have. That's all. Sughatakashah mahakashaiti yukte. But you can't help it because the world just gives reality to that alone all the time. Keep on always justifying emotion, justifying the needs. Yes, you need this and you need to do this support and you need this nourishment. All kinds of stuff we are told. The ego requires nourishment and this requires nourishment and they keep on nourishing it. It's a never-ending process, you know. So you can never end. Nourishment of ego, you know, up to a certain point is okay, but otherwise it's an important. So Mahatkham, Kumbhakam, that is why the Vedants are very fond of giving this example of space. More than even refraction and so forth, that also is okay, it's also wonderful. But then this example of space can help a person actually see how the idea of a shape is something that is superimposed upon the space. So how Vartikara takes these statements here and fits this passage into the conventional Mahavakya declaration, you know, and shows here that this is Mahavakya, not only Mahavakya, but elaborates the whole process of how Mahavakya seeks to convey the knowledge by the Vishesha, Vishesha Bhava and so forth, how Mahavakya does. So this is actually done here. And in fact, the Vishesha, Vishesha Bhava has been stated here. And thereby, revealing the contradiction by saying Mahakasha is Ghatakasha is Mahakasha, the idea is to reveal the contradiction and let it drop. The next verse says 983 Ishitavyatva Nivrittav Phalitamaha. And so when the jiva, the vijnanamaya atma, is released from the idea of ishtavyatva, or being ruled, phalitamaha, so what does it amount to? What's the result? The verse is, ishtavyanupattau cha tadapekshaika samshrayad ishitvam api nissesham praticho vinivartate. Ishtavyanu pattavcha. No, apanuttavcha. Ishtavya apanuttavcha. So when Ishtavya is apanutam, meaning it is removed, tat apeksha eka samshayat ishitvopi nissesham praticha vinivartate. Then tat apeksha eka samshayat. That Ishtavya also is totally dependent upon the Ishtavya. Ishitvam. So he's called Sarveshwara. That Sarveshwaratva also should go away. So he's called Sarveshwara here. That is to eliminate the idea of Ishitavyatva. But when Ishitavya means the ruled goes away, the Ishwara also goes away. Ishitavya apanattavcha tadapekshaika samshayat. Ishitvam. So Ishitvam, which is what? Tadapeksha. Ishitavya apeksha eka samshayat. So Ishvatvam, or being the ruler, is totally dependent upon the idea of being ruled. Nishesham praticha vinivartate, and therefore even the Ishvaratvam, Sarveshwara, Bhutadipati, Bhutapalaha, all of these also get the Jivatma becomes completely released from that also. And therefore a wise man never feels that I am Ishvara. If he feels, then there is some problem. Ishvara means he feels that I am a ruler. Then there is a problem there also, because the rulership also merely at the level of upadhi. Therefore, that is why we say, how would one feel if one were the ruler? One would feel free, that's all. When I am the ruler, I am not ruled by anybody, then I am free to do whatever I want, or not to do what I want. I am free from all kind of restrictions, free from all compulsions, basically. So when I am controlled, then I am always compelled by the one who controls me. And therefore the one who is controlled or ruled always feels compelled. Therefore by calling him the ruler or the controller, what is meant to say is, he becomes free from all compulsions. Sarvatha vartamanavi sayogi mahi vartate. That however he conducts himself, he still is always established in me. Not that he will conduct himself in any way, there is no need. But the idea is that there is no compulsion at all. So that is called freedom. Bondage is when I feel compelled. This I can't say, this I cannot do, this I cannot, you know, and so forth and so on. That's the compulsion. And of course, everybody feels that way, because there is always something to be lost. If I say something, then it may go against me. So as long as there is something to be protected, so long it is necessary for me to conduct myself in a certain way, because I need to protect my image. Whatever it is that I have to protect, my ego and image and, I don't know, prestige and, I don't know, whatever it is. When there is nothing to protect, then there is no compulsion. So this is called moksha, that freedom is something like that only. That freedom from compulsion, because there is nothing to hold on to. There is nothing to protect, there is nothing to, no agenda at all. And therefore, na bhavati kutaschaneti, he is not afraid of anything because he has nothing to hold on to. Basically, fear also is at the emotional level, and there, because there is a need always to protect something. Because I seek security from something, and whatever it is that I am seeking security from, I have to hold on to that. When I don't seek security, there is nothing to protect, in which case, there is nothing to hold on to. And that is how a person is free. So, ever being Ishvara also is a problem. That I must rule somebody and control somebody, that also is samsara only. If I am controlled, that is samsara. Then I am controller, that is also samsara. And therefore, a wise person becomes free from both the samsara. He is neither controlled, nor does he have to control anybody. Ishitvam api nishesham, nishesham without living any shesha, praticha nivinivartate, from pratyagatma, that also goes away. Pratijana will be the fifth case. Tatascha tika says, tatascha nirvishesham pratyang matram tishthati nibhavah. So what remains is nirvishesham pratyang matram. Nirvishesham chaitanyam. All that remains is, who am I? None other than nirvishesham chaitanyam. So Vedanta all the time seeks to only drop all the visheshas. A process that is totally different from the what we call the samsara. So that is called samsara, where there is always an attempt to acquire visheshata. Because one sees one's greatness in the visheshata and the upadhi. And Vedanta wants us to discover the greatness by dropping the visheshata. Anyway, so that's how it is. Whether it is the ornament that make the Sitaji beautiful, or the ornaments become beautiful because of her? Is it the upadhi that makes me great? All the greatness in upadhi is because of me. I think that the upadhi makes me great. It's the other way around. Because of me. I think that the world makes me happy. It's the other way around. The happiness that anything gives me is because of me. Just turn around the idea, that's all. As simple as that. Except that it appears so complicated because right now the complicated thing has become our nature. A person has become so complex and therefore simple thing appears to be very complicated. Tatasya nirvisesham pratyang matram. There are lots of printing errors here. Tishtati nibhavaha. Mahadityadana, next one. Mahadityadana uktam dushtantam prapanchayati. Mahatkham kumbakham yatha. So, ityadana uktam dushtantam da dushtantam prapanchayati. So, mahatkham kumbakham. How the mahatva and kumbhatva goes away? The next verse is, verse 984 says, घटाकाशो महाकाशः इत्युक्ते कुंभकहनुतौ आकाशमात्रताशेषः यथैवेह तथात्मनि. घटाकाशो महाकाशः इत्युक्ते, when it said घटाकाश is महाकाश, then कुंभकहनुतौ, so there is a नखनुति, अपखनुति means the removal of kumbhaka, kumbhatvam, so kumbhaka means ghatakashatvam, so that ghatakashatvam goes away. When ghata, that we already discussed, when ghatakasha is equal to mahakasha, the ghatatvam from the akasha goes away. And then mahatvam also goes away. Understand that mahatvam is always a reference to ghatatvam. So bigness is always a reference to smallness. You call it Mahakasha, that means great Akasha, is always a reference to small Akasha. Because Akasha is qualified by partness or smallness, therefore some Akasha becomes great. But when that smallness smallness goes away, then the bigness also doesn't remain, all that remains is Akasha. So, Akashamatrata Sheshaha, how all that remains is Akashamatrata, nothing but Akasha. Yatha eva tatha atmani, yatha eva iha. So just as it is there, iha tatha atmani iha. Similarly here also in Atma, all that remains is merely Chaitanyam. That is Dashrandika, iha tatha atmani. So similarly when Jiva is equal to Ishvara, all that remains is Nirvishesha Chaitanyam. How? Tadeva spashtayati, next verse. So how Mahavakya analysis is so beautifully done here, you know. Mahavakya tatparyam. Viruddhayoho asamsargaha yatha evam avirdhayoho tad abodha samuchittau avakyartha avashishyate. So viruddhayo asamsarga hai, tika says, padartha dvayastha sadvayatva parokshatvayo ho na brahmatma bhyam samsarga hai mitho viruddhatvat evam pratyaktva advayatvayo ho api na anyonyam anvaya hai tayo ho ekatvat ataha brahmatma jnana dhvastav ekarasam vastu syadityatah. Padartha dvayastha sadvayatva parokshatvayoho. So jiva and Ishvara or Brahma. So in jiva padartha dvayastha sadvayatva. But jiva is sadvaya. So jivas are many. So in vijnanamaya atma is always the idea of one among the many. Or being separated from others, being different from others, sadvayatva is there. And when there is an idea of Brahma, parokshatva, that Brahma or God is different from me. So these are the inbuilt ideas. with reference to me, there is idea of smallness always involved. I know myself intimately, but I know myself a small, limited entity. One among the many, different from the others, and therefore limited in time, space and everywhere. As far as God is concerned, I give him all the benefit that he is limitless, but then he is paroksha, he is different from me. And so, one is a paroksha, other is paroksha. One is sadvayatva, other is advaya. Sadvaya and advaya.
So, viruddhayo asamsargaha.
There cannot be samsarga, any kind of relationship of visheshana visheshyatva also between these two entities that are totally contradictory. And so, samanadikaranyatvam visheshana visheshyata lakshya lakshana bhavascha padartha pratyagatmana. So, with padartha and vachyartha, when we say visheshana visheshyata, then we find them totally contradictory to each other. Therefore, they cannot be samsarga, they cannot enjoy the visheshana visheshya bhava.
Yatha evam aviruddhayoho
tad abodha samuchittau. And therefore, brahmātma ajñāna dhastau. So when there is samuchiti, or when there is dhasti, thus when there is elimination or dispelling of the ignorance of Brahma, identity of Brahma and Atma, so Tika said, so padartha dvayastha sadvayatva parokshatvayoho na brahmātma bhyam samsarga mitho viruddhatvat. Since both of these are contradictory, sadvayatva and parokshatva means what? Sadvayatva and advayatva and parokshatva and parokshatva. That is how they are contradictory. So, sadvayatva cannot mean Brahma and parokshatva cannot mean Atma, the Brahmatma bhyam. So, same anukrama is to be taken in the samasa. So, sadvayatva, parokshatva, yoho, and Brahmatma bhyam. So, there is a contradiction that sadvayatva, the divinity, cannot mean Brahma, and parokshatva cannot mean Atma. Now, we are told that Brahma is Atma. I know Atma is a paroksha. And therefore, it cannot have that parokshatvam which I think is in Brahma. And Brahma is advitiyam. And that cannot have a sadvayatva which I take for granted in the Atma.
So, Brahma Atma bhyam samsargaha na mitho viruddhatvat.
So, because there is a mutual contradiction, therefore, there cannot be samsarga. Samsarga means visheshana visheshya bhava cannot be there. Samsargova, visheshtova, vakyartho, natya sammataha. Akhandaikara sattvena, vakyartho, vidushaam mataha. Samsarga and visheshta. So, samsarga was visheshana visheshya bhava. So, each one qualifying the other. So, jiva becomes a visheshana, jivatva becomes a visheshana of Ishvara, and Ishvara becomes a visheshana of jiva, Ishvaratva. That is called samsarga. And when only jivatva becomes visheshana of Ishvara or vice versa, then it becomes vishesha. That is how it was explained. Another way of explaining is that samsarga is, so Rama, Dandena, Gamanaya, so how every word is connected, that is called samsarga. The relationship that the different words enjoy in a sentence also, that's another way of looking at it. So however you look at it, samsarga is not. But here, so visheshana visheshatva, that the jiva and Ishvara is implied in the Mahavakya, Tattvamasi, when both of them are equated, it is implied that Tat and Tvam enjoy the visheshana vishesha samsarga. Each one becomes the visheshana of the others and becomes vishesha, qualified by the other. And mitho viruddhatvat, since both this is contradictory, that jiva cannot become visheshana of Brahma. Because jiva possesses sadvayatva. And therefore, sadvayatva or being one among many cannot be the visheshana of Brahma. And Brahma cannot become visheshana of jiva. Brahma is paroksha. And jiva is a paroksha. Brahma cannot become visheshana of jiva. And jiva cannot become visheshana of Brahma. So, that's samsarga. That each one becoming visheshana of the others and becoming visheshya with reference to other, that is not possible because this viruddhatva is there. Contradiction is there. Viruddhayoho asamsargaha. So, asamsarga. That visheshana visheshya bhava cannot be between the two.
यथा सो यथा विरुद्धयो असंसर्गः एवं अविरुद्धयोः
एवं देन हियर इट सेज एवं प्रत्यक्त्व अद्वयत्वयोः अपि न अन्योन्यमन्वयः
ऑल राइट देन
आत्मा इज व्हाट प्रत्यगात्मा प्रत्यक्त्व एंड ब्रह्म इज व्हाट अद्वय सो दीज टू थिंग्स आर इन जीवात्मा एंड टू थिंग्स आर इन ब्रह्म जीवात्मा इज व्हाट प्रत्यक एंड सद्वय अपरोक्ष एंड सद्वय एंड ब्रह्म इज व्हाट परोक्ष एंड अद्वय सो विरुद्ध अंश इज व्हाट सद्वयत्व एंड परोक्षत्व विरुद्ध अंश व्हेन दे आर गिवन अप व्हाट रिमेन्स इज अपरोक्षत्व एंड अद्वितीयत्व कैन देयर बी रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन देम कैन अद्वितीयत्व एंड एंड अपरोक्षत्व कैन दे एंजॉय नाउ दैट द रिमेनिंग एलिमेंट्स So, virudha elements are given up, the remaining elements, can they also have a sambandha? Can they be related as vishesha and vishesha? Or can they be related in any way, like the part and the whole or whatever it is? They cannot be. So, evam, pratyaktva advayatvayoho api na anyonyam anvayah. That means they also cannot be related to each other. Why? Ekatva. Because both are one. So, see the two which are totally contradictory each other also cannot be related and one also cannot be related to oneself. So, aparokshatvam cannot be related to advityatvam because they are one. And that is how there also anvaya. Anvaya means what? Here a sambandha cannot be. Either samsarga or visheshana cannot be there. Atah, this is how the mind will work. That's how the mind works. That it sees contradictory elements, says this can't be, drops it. The non-contradictory element are one, then also there is no sambandha. That's how, without any avakyartham. This interesting thing here is that, tat abodha samuchittau avakyartha avashishyate. I was at some point wondering, I said, what is going on here? Vakyartha avashishyate, that's what I was, but then I said, avakyartham. Vakyartha means what? The way conventionally a vakya or a sentence conveys the meaning. A sentence conveys the meaning either by samsarga or vishesha. That's called vakyartha. But this mahavakya in fact cannot convey the meaning either way. Therefore it's called avakyartha. That means the artha that is conveyed here by unconventional. So by dropping the conventional format of samsarga and vishesha, that is how conventionally vakya actually conveys the meaning. When then none of them is applicable, still the artha is there. That's avakya. Artha is what? Aikya. Because in a vakya you cannot have two words meaning the same thing. Either there must be pariyaya. But pariyaya is not there. Bhinna pravritti nimittanam, seka vivyaktikanam, padanam. So, tat and tvam have different pravritti. They are not pariyaya. They don't have the same meaning. And therefore you would think that they are related in some way. That's the reason why other acharyas have all interpreted Mahavakya in some relationship. That tat is in some way related to tvam. And there is amsham, shi, dasabha, and you know, so forth and so on. And that is how swami, swaswami. And this is how some relationship is found. Although it is established much earlier, you know, that the relationship cannot be. That they are in fact identical in the primary sense. But this seems to create some problem with everybody. How can I be Ishvara? So, to say that God does not have Ishvaratvam, I can't accept it. Or, the other fellow may think that how can I say, I am a Jiva, you know, and therefore I am an insignificant creature. How can insignificance be given up? So, other fellow can give up that. And therefore that we must retain. And then understand the Upanishad. Then you come up with some all kinds of interpretations. Says, why? So that requires a tremendous boldness, emotional boldness, to say that Ishvara also ultimately needs the why not? Why should you imagine that God has to rule you? All that he must require a rulership to rule, why can't he rule you by his very presence? That's even greatest rulership. That he must have weapons and he must control everybody and that is how keep everything under control. Why should that be necessary? Why can not be like Lord Krishna, you know, who just has his flute on his lips, and just by his very presence he controls everything. Maya adhyakshena prakritihi suyate sacharacharam.
For the prakriti to create and sustain and dissolve, nothing more than my presence is needed. That's all. So Bhashyakara shows that how his presence, the consciousness is there. Everything originates from consciousness, every thought originates from consciousness, and it becomes a desire, and it becomes an action, it gives rise to experience, which resolves in consciousness. So everything evolves from, originates from consciousness, merges back into consciousness, results into consciousness or knowledge, and also is pervaded by knowledge or consciousness when it is there, and therefore it is consciousness or the knowledge or intelligence, whatever you want to call it. Its mere presence is enough for everything to be ruled. And therefore, to say that God is a ruler in the primary sense, we are limiting Him. Because we are assigning a personality to Him. And when we assign personality to God as a ruler, then He is stuck with all kinds of consequences of ruling somebody. Ruling somebody can be very sinful act, actually, as a matter of fact, But when you rule somebody, means you are controlling somebody. That means that you are in fact denying them the freedom and whatever it is that you are doing in order to rule. And you can't get away with that, you cannot get away. By limiting, controlling somebody, by ruling or whatever, by creating, causing pain. Ishvara must rule in such a way that he doesn't cause pain to anybody or he doesn't have to make an effort. Therefore, he is always lying on his sheshasaya. Although he may be a niyanta and protector, he is there always, doesn't have to do anything. By mere presence, things should happen. So this is the highest concept of rulership. The highest concept of rulership is when no real attempt at ruling is required. The highest concept of leadership, where then that can only happen when you must become great. See, you want to remain small and you want to be ruler, then you must manipulate. So all the manipulations come because the one who is in a position of leadership is a small person. He wants to remain small and still wants to remain a leader, become a leader, and therefore the only way it can be done is by manipulation, by maneuvering. That's called politics. But in order to rule or in order to lead, the other way is to become great. And then the ruling or leading will not require effort, or become effort will be less and less. At the level of Ishvara, the effort is zero. That's the kind of perfection that Vedanta is seeking. Not even seeking, that perfection is there. Just own up that perfection. So don't try to rule. Don't try to rule, but don't try to manipulate and then deny the greatness that you have. That you are capable of ruling, if ruling is what you need. That is that right now, this is Esha Sarvesha, all this stuti is done. Because that is the incentive. That's the incentive that a person has to become wise. If I become wise, I become Sarveshwara. Bhutadhipati, Bhutapala, Sarvasya Vashi, Sarvasya Ishanaha. And so, that kind of thing he wants to become. But then, only when he discovers that this is also not a qualification. The mere presence can be described as Sarvasya Vashi. So ultimately, this becomes a description of mere presence. Sarvasya Vashi. Sarvasya Ishana, Sarvasya Adhipatihi. So Vedantic teachers are extremely, you can see, where their vision is. This may look like all arithmetic, or algebra and stuff. It's not algebra. It is something that one has to do in one's life. And this is the goal one has. It's to simplify, and that is all where Vairagya comes. Dropping. This is to be dropped. When shirt is given up and car is given up, that is all stuff is okay. But really what is to be dropped is ultimately this. Anyway, tat abodha samuchyattav. Abodha means ajnana, anavabodha. So brahmatma ajnana dhvastav. When the ignorance of brahma and atma, the identity, when the ignorance is dispelled, then what? Avakyartha avashishyate. That's why Panchadashikara said, so samsargova visishtova vakyartho nata sammadaha akhandaikara sattvena vakyartha vidusham mataha. So vidvan, vidusham, so wise people say that akhandaikara sattvena vinutadantvam akhandaikara sattvam ekara sattvam akhandaikara sattvam, meaning total homogeneity, total oneness.
admitting of no duality or no relationship whatever. Avakyartha avashishyate. Avakyartha means a vakya, yartha, which doesn't have samsarga or visheshta. Because whenever we understand a sentence, it always leaves an impression. So when a sentence is uttered in our mind, we always connect the words of the sentence. And that's how the words are related, qualified, some impression residue is left, that's called vakyartha. Avakyartha. This statement is understood without leaving any of that residue. Ekarasan vasu syada, it is syarityata, syada. Ukta vakshamanayoho, paunuruktyam pariharan, ukta manudya vakshamanam patijanite. Ukta vakshamanayoho, uktam, what has been stated, vakshamana, what is to be stated, paunuruktyam pariharan, that there is no punarukti, there is no tautology, not just repetition. Pariharan uktam anudya vakshamanam pratijanite. Uktam anudya, reiterating what is stated, vakshamanam pratijanite. Then Vartikar here does the pratijna, proposes what is to be stated. Reiterating or repeating what is stated, proposes or presents what is to be stated, aidam priyamiti. So you can see the title, that tatparam uktam padartha pratipadyate. Mahavakya tatpariya has been stated. Avakyartha avashishyate akhandaikarasatvena vakyartho vidushammata. This Mahavakya tatpariya. Now, padartha pratipadyate. Tatpada, tvampada, padartha pratipadyate. If you don't see that sequence, you may understand, we feel that he is just going round and round. It's not. There is a whole thing. The Tikagara sees that thing very well. As to how, first of all, the tatpari of the whole kandika is given. And tatpari of the avayava is given. And then the padartha of the avayava is given. Aidam parividam tavada padarthodha padarthaha asa adhuno adhuna uchyate. Savayati vachovartasya vyakhyatatvana yatyate. Aidam paryam idam tavata. So, idam tavata, aidam paryam. So, this is how, it has been so far, you know, in the Madhya Mahavakya. Meaning that the Vakyartha, the Tatpari, the Mahavakya has been explained. Padarthaha asa adhuna uchyate. So the tatpari the Mahavakya having been now given, stated or described or explained, asa adhuna padarthaha uchyate. Now we are going to say the pada saha and esha. So here the equation is between saha and esha. And so that is also, it is said esha sarveshwara, esha bhutadipatihi, esha bhutapala. There also esha, esha, esha. The Vartikara said that Saha refers to Jivatma, Esha refers to the Chaitanya. So the Esha Sarveshwara, this Chaitanya is Sarveshwara, you know, and that is how Sarveshwaratvam itself is Upadikam. Is also when Esha and Sarveshwara are equated, that is also it is stated how Sarveshwaratvam is Upadikam. Okay, padartha sa adhuna uchyate. So now the padartha, the meaning of the pada is being stated. Then Tikagara says, padarthanamapi prageva arthad uktatvat tadavastha punaruktihi. Looks like that you are just repeating yourself. Why should you even say padartha? Mahavakyartha also stated, and padartha also is stated, meaning what is the meaning of jiva, ishvara is all stated earlier. Padarthanavi prageva arthad uktatvat. Arthad meaning, so arthapatya. So, by implication, it is already, meaning of the words has already been stated. Tadavastha punaruktihi. So, punarukti remains. Tadavastha means it remains. That means you have not yet removed the fault of punarukti. Savayati. So, all of this, savayesha, mahanajatma, etc., all of this is punarukti because everything has been stated. So, padarthanavi pragevartha duktatva tadavastha punarukti hityashankyah savayati. So, the next line says, sava iti vachavartasya vyakhyatatvana yatyate. So, we already stated earlier what saha means, jivatma. Vadeshaha means is the Shuddhatma. So, Savayadi Vachaha Arthasya. So, Vachaha means your word, Vakya, or the individual words also. So, what are the meaning of these two words? Vyakhyatatvat, since they have been explained, na yatyate. There is no attempt made here to explain them again. Then Tikagara says, Tathapi katham atma iti arabhya yaduktam tena paunaruktyam iti ashankya. Tathapi katham atma, all this is explanation of Bhashya here. Yeah, on page 1276. Is that right? Or... Page 12, katam atma, katam eshaidi uchyade, vijnanam, praneshaidi, ukta vaktyo linganam, samshayana vrityartham, ukta vipuram, janaka prasnarambe, katam atma edi, vijnanam, praneshaidi. So, there is a vakya that is being explained. Yet uktam bhavati, yoyam vijnanam, praneshaidi, vakyana pripadida, swayam jyotir atma, Sayesha kama karma vidyana manatma dharmatva prativadana dvarana mukshitaha paramatma apadidaha parevayam nanyiti isha sa sakshan mahanaja atma iti uktaha. Yoyam vijnanam pranasadu yatha vakhyata eva. That is already been explained in Jyotir Brahmana. So, Tika said, tathabi katamatma iti arabhya iduktam tena paunaruktim ashtankya. So, all right, still, see, this savayesha mahanajatma, the Purupakshi says that all this statement is just punarukti. Because in the Jyotir Brahmana, the meaning of this vijnanamayatma has been explained elaborately. So, katamatma iti arabhyayaduktam, in Jyotir Brahmana, so when Janaka asked the question, katamatma, then this was said, yayesha, yoyam vijnanamaya praneshurudyantya jyotir purusha, etc. Tena punaruktam. This looks like just the punarukti of what was stated there, iti ashankya. Tasevacha atra upanishad bhaga atyagena hetuktyarthatvena anuvada. This is not punarukti but anuvada. This is anuvada, this is already stated earlier. So the reason why these statements are repeated here is to show so that some words must be there. So this is to show that the entire Veda has its application in the in the Brahmatma Jnanam, the entire Veda. So that is why this Brahmatma Jnanam, the knowledge of the identity of Brahma and Jiva, is what is being stated here in that the earlier passage. To show how the entire Veda has its application in this knowledge. So that is already said. And therefore, nanudyat bahun shabda, that you must not repeat too many words or think of too many words. That means some words you should dwell upon, or think of, and then the word Upanishad. So, Bahun Shabdhan meaning all the words that is Karmakanda section, one should not now think of anymore. But then, you must be devoted now to thinking of the words of Upanishad. That is why, in fact, Shruti does Anuvada, repetition, or now reiteration here, of the words of Upanishad. That this is what you should think of. That is why it is said here, Tasseva chatra Upanishad bhaga atyagena. The Upanishad bhaga should not be given up. Atyagena. Hetu uktyarthatvena anuvadat. So therefore, Savayesha Mahanajatma, all of this is stated here to imply that the Upanishad Bhaga should not be given up. And that, so this becomes a hetu. That is the reason why this is being repeated here. Hetu uktyarthatven anuvadat. And so that's the reason, this is presented as a hetu as to how these few words should not be given up. So therefore this anuvada is done. The idea is that the same words are repeated here, which is anuvada, because that is how the hetu, the reason is being stated as to why the Upanishad Bhaga should not be given up. And therefore, na punarukti, this anuvada and not punarukti. Idyaha tasya. Okay. Artha vyakhyatattva na yattade tad vyakhyanaya bhuyopi. Therefore, we are not attempting here to explain it because all this is explained earlier. Tasya chaiha anuvadatah. And why is this stated? Because anuvada, not punarukti. So, this is not punarukti. That's why Bhashyakara had to give all this, you know, bhumika as to how this passage is meant to show how the entire Veda has its application in Brahmatma Jnana. Tutasya chaiha anuvadatah. Since this is the anuvada, therefore this is not punarukti. Okay, we can continue tomorrow. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam Sutra Bhashya Krutau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah Ishvaro Guru Ratmedi Murti Bheda Vibhagine Vyoma Vadvyapta Dehaya Dakshina Murtaye Namah Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.